Hi everyone, welcome to Dataverse Academy. In today's video, we will learn how we can create a KQL database and then we will load a file from our local system.
Log into your Microsoft Fabric account, then click on Synapse Real-Time Analytics. Here, click on KQL Database. Provide name to your database. Then click on Create. Our database is created successfully. So here you can see we can get the data from local system, from our one lake, from blob container, and from blob storage, and through event streaming, and through data pipeline. But in this video, we will load a file from our local system. So for that, click on Get Data. Then click on local file. Then provide the table name in which we will load our file. Then click on next source. Now upload your file. Then click on next schema. I have a CSV file which I am loading into the database. So that's why my format is CSV. And if you are loading the other format file, you can choose that. It can be JSON, text, Avro, Packet. And suppose in the first row you have the data, then you can uncheck it. But in my first row, I have header. That's why I have checked it. Then click on Next Summary. You can see our file is loaded successfully. Click on close. Here you can see this table. Click on it. Go below. These are the columns which we have in our table. If you want to check the data, then click on these three dots. Then click on query table. Then click on show any 100 rows. We got the output. Now suppose if you want to check the record count, then you can do this. Select it and click on run. We have these number of records. Close it. Now suppose if you want to check the records last 24 hours, click on it. Then click on query table. Then click on this. It will give you the records which we have inserted in last 24 hours in this table. Writing KQL is pretty simple. You need to write table name, then pipe, then you need to write your condition. So this is my table name and where condition, and this is the function which store record ingestion time. Now is the current date and time. These are the basic query in KQL. Selecting the data, checking the record count, and checking the last 24 hour record count. Close this. If you are not familiar with the KQL, Microsoft Fabric has provided SQL to analyze the data within the KQL database. So for that, click on these three dots, then query table, then select SQL, then click on show any 100 records. Here you can see we got our output. And suppose if you want to check the number of records in our table, so for that, select count star from table. Select it, then click on run. Here you can see the output. And now suppose you want to check the number of records per month. So for that, write select month from account star from bank account group by month. Select it then run. Here you can see number of records each month. So this is how you can use the SQL query within the KQL database. Close this. That's it in this video. In the next video, we will learn how we can use the KQL query set, and then we will build the Power BI dashboard over that query set. Thank you for watching this video.